check this out, y'all. You knew her, as I said earlier, as an ex-homosexual. You know him as a brother who didn't break the chains of the soul ties. And the glory, the height of glory, he's done reached the height of glory. Y'all check that one out, it's a good one. You know what I'm saying? And you also know him as a brother that did like the cool, did one of the tightest, like the second tightest wedding proposal surprise after mine. Now they married and they having a baby. Please welcome to the stage, Jackie and Preston Perry.
So I guess it was convenient for you to turn your back on the woman who held your spine.
Woman, you were brought forth from my side, created to support me like the gravity-stricken moon does the brisk breath of nightfall. But when fear clawed its way into my heart, when he called my name in the garden, you shrunk and hid your shameful body.
Where were you when the Prince of Night found his way to your star? You watched him lie, and I watched you sit and set like sun, you mourning of a man. You can't even see the nightmare you have become.
I was there. Standing in the distance, having a conversation with my backbone. I wanted to stop you, but you let that evil reptile with eyes, slow dancing with deceit and tongue, swift as breeze, woo you dumb to think we could be wise as the God who thought the galaxies into existence.
Adam, I thought he was my friend, letting me in on secrets God Pinky promised the leaves not to tell. He pointed me to the tree, told me what I was missing, and as my faith in his lies led me to stare, I watched death become gorgeous.
But God is beautiful.
Adam, my tongue became sight. The fruit looked too good not to taste
and see that God is good.
God is thief. He kept us from the one thing he knew would turn our minds deity.
No, God is wise, Eve, can't you see? In our feast for knowledge, we have become fools. Searching for wisdom in a mere branch, we forgot about the God who had the power to grow us from dust with no roots. His mind is wide as sky, and we were free as clouds, but now the silent hum of shame echoes the land. The eerie chill of Father's curse crawls across our conscience, and the very river we bathe our naked souls in is damned because of you. What have you done?
Do not blame me for murder and name yourself victim as if we are not both ghosts with skin.
You left me for dead.
Did you forget the sixth day when God made you from dust.
But he made you from me for me. While sleeping, he called you from my cage, bones beautiful, but you, with your prideful disposition, switched positions and tried to lead. Took heed to a four-legged snake without consulting me first. You didn't respect me.
He gave you authority. He made you the head of us, but you became neck. I can still see the apple stuck in your throat, Adam. Swallow your pride. You were supposed to lead me, yet I am to blame. Your wife, your Eve, the one who is now shame, once beauty the moment you saw her breathe. Maybe I should noose a ribbon around my neck, make a skirt of wrapping paper, stuff my natural naked chest with leaves. Maybe then these bones will be enough gift for you again, this flesh enough body for you to bathe in. The day you remove God from your soul, emptied your nest of his glories, the day you beg me to take his place, fill your voids, become this image of perfection to satisfy your insecurities.
God forbid.
Our sons grow up treating their sisters like cemeteries, stacking their bodies and bones in one closet to wear as one flesh every time they want to feel alive.
Eve, please understand that you further prove my point. That prideful organ brewing beneath your breast beats with no submission for your husband. And for this, your future daughters would not be quiet, gentle, but some would be loud as nagging crows scavenging on the dead earlobes of men. Their bodies, sculpted for God's glory, will become lures enticing our sons to sin, and they will. These women, your offspring, will hand their souls over to men who are not their God. They will kneel for value at the altar of man's approval, but that worship would not make them whole nor holy.
Do you see what you've done? You made this about you by blaming me. We are both sin wrapped in flesh, both broken creations, stained glass windows with no shine, no sun, no light. We are both dark, imperfect, lost.
We are fallen. Wife, I'm sorry. Have you any idea how shameful my inside screamed for not protecting the only woman I've ever known and loved from the sting of death? I feel like a lonely grave, wallowing in a walking coffin of a body, waiting for a voice louder than my fears to resurrect the scared corpse of a man I buried 6 feet under guilt. But believe me when I tell you, you are still the woman my vision sung to when I first saw you in Eden, Eve, even if God chose to separate us for 1,000 years for what we have done. I'll write you every day faithful, and my letters will literally litter the land with love, my lady. But excuse me if the blood on my hands still drips thick with condemnation. I can only pray that this venom doesn't poison our unborn son, Cain. There is nothing but murder living in my genes, and I would die if he follows in his father's footsteps.
Husband, forgive me in my limbs and the heart that led them away from the safety of your palms. The parachute folded beneath the bloodstream I left in vain. I promise I will never try to fly without you again. Your word is wind, and I would be fooled to disrespect the tornado I was created to love. You mentioned our sons, but remember our God. Remember what he told devil as he cursed serpent. He spoke of my womb, and from it a seed will come. The devil will strike his heel, but our seed will crush his head. Yes, we are dying, but one day we may rise from the dead. We are not hopeless. Mercy has its sights set on the sinners, and its source is our God.
He will rescue us out of the sea of sin.
Like hands beneath a drowning soul, a rainbow before the lightning bolt speaks, he reigns.
When the clouds crack their shell, our God will appear and show us his yoke is easy.
A light too mighty for anything pitch black to trap our backs back behind that cage we crave. The way of escape is near if we wait with hope, nailed to our faith. The truth cross-stitched to our burdened bodies. The life stretching like the arms of an horizon, rising for all to see. The sun still lives.
Eve, forgive me.
Adam, forgive me.
God. We tried to be our own God.
Please forgive us.